pirate stations respond to their attempt by actually trying to consolidate their own strengths, by actually saying, well, we won't be one record away from a hit. Actually, we won't actually play any kind of music which is at that junction point between the kind of pop culture and our sort of soul underground. In fact, some of the more articulate pirate stations say, look, we're not just dealing with music here, we're dealing with a culture, with a lifestyle, and we'll defend that culture against the encroachments of this overground, exploitative, blood-sucking kind of commercial culture, which is represented, you know, by, I don't know, Tony Blackburn or Steve Walsh or the Radio London Soul Night Out, the attempt to kind of reconnect that official broadcasting with the club scene and things like that.
And when you're talking about radio, and particularly when the commercial radio comes along, I'm afraid, they're going to have to get an audience, and they're not going to get an audience by playing very obscure tracks, as great as they might be. What I do, I intermingle those obscure tracks with very commercial sounds, like Five Star, and if they remember, those very pirates, before Five Star had enormous hits, were playing those records at very regular intervals. But now, of course, they've become popular. Oh, no, we can't touch them anymore. It's not street cred, man. Street credibility they go for. Street credibility is all right for them, but in the real world, you have to get audiences, otherwise, you're out.
The legal stations have tried to adapt their presentation to outflank the pirates, to say, well, actually, we can deal with this culture as well. We can represent this voice, which is not being represented anywhere else. We can connect up with these audiences, these new publics, which have actually been uncovered by the proliferation of pirate radio. And of course, as they try and match the pirates, they also have to adapt that musical culture so it fits their own format. And that plays, I think, quite a destructive role.
But there are people who don't want to be educated. They just want pure music and pure entertainment, as we have on satellite broadcasting now. And that's wonderful, because they must realize now that when we start educating, for people who don't want to be educated, what do? They switch it off. Simple as that. There is room for those of us who actually just want pure, unadulterated entertainment.
Feel no way, JBC's here to stay on the big frequency of 105 FM. Oh yeah, I'm telling you, man. All the ladies hold tight, I'll be playing the tracks for you just a little bit later on.
It's a raid. Get the camera ready. We're on the raid now.
They're raiding now.
The stereo.
Right. No, just keep this tape, go for the unit. And get the other equipment out.
Just get your cameras coming. Nice one, you come the right side. Wait, all right.
Okay, don't worry.
Just get your cameras, they're coming in, man. Wonderful. Great. You're a superstar now, Guts.
It's going to be on 10 here. You ready?
No, just wait. We're going to get you on Kelly.
What? You ready?
Wait, hold on. We got you on Kelly.
Someone is there.
Just let them wait. They're raining. Nice one. Right. Superstar now, Guts. You're on Telly, my friend.
You're on Telly.
Who was playing the records?
No one was playing any record, man. We had a tape in. We just pulled the tape out of the machine.
Would you mind staying here? Don't leave.
He came in while you're coming in.
You're teaching him the run-ins, Guts, like you don't know it.
You do not have to say anything unless you wish to do so, but what you say may be given in evidence. Do you understand the caution? Yes, we'll have to say nothing.
No, man, you've got the right to go over there.
Don't go over there.
No, you can't go over there.
Without arguing, we can search the whole premises.
Mr. Guts, you know we always play fair with you.
Well, where's the bit that's missing?
What bit?
The code is nothing. Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
You've dismantled it, so where is it?
Well, I didn't dismantle it because I was outside.
We don't want to search a whole premises. So where is it?
Can I have your name and address?
Ian Johnson.
Ian Johnson.
Put that light out, please.
Long Z.
CWE. Age?
Over 25. And
your age? 18.
18?
Yeah.
Excuse please.
Pull the door open.
Raids like that are a comment on the nature of British radio. For most of its history, it's been a severely restricted system, slow to respond to popular tastes. It was a system guaranteed to produce a challenge. For the last 20 years, pirate radio has been a persistent feature of British broadcasting. In that time, it's undoubtedly changed what we hear on the radio. The emergence of a large number of new legal stations, as proposed in the Green Paper on broadcasting, should mean that the gaps the pirates are filling will no longer exist. Pirate radio, as we've known it, is likely to become a thing of the past. How should it be remembered? What if one of the new national stations proposed by the government were a black station of the kind pioneered by DBC, Solar and LWR? Perhaps that would be a suitable memorial.
That's all from us for tonight. We hope you enjoyed the show. We hope to be back with you real soon. Thank you, and good night.